Hello, YouTube. Lost Galaxy. I'm here with another episode of Delta V. Saturn's of rings. Yes, rings of Saturn. I got done figuring out a bunch of stuff in the last episode, like how I'm reading the date wrong, and it's next month they get paid, not next day. It's next day they get paid. And also, I did check. The crew is getting better. Like, there's no change on the experience right now, but they're getting objectively better. This has went from a point 0.2 seconds from a 0.1. This has gone from 1% to 2%. This has gone up significantly. This hasn't changed much, but I think this has gone up by a day. So let's check out how much money it's going to take to get there. It's 11,600. So I buy all the propellant again because I used all of it to get back. But I'm now actually going to let the thing drift for 4 days and get over there and mine it out, or like pay for it to get there and pay for it to get. It's gonna be 8 days in the entire trip, so I'll have all 80 kegs of propellant. I'll save a little bit from maneuvering in case things get hairy, like an attack or something. I tune the ship. To recap what I did last time, I put you at maximum, jackass. Now that's the thing I have to be careful with, is I can't actually knock my ship out from power loss due to me using the gun now. Due to that, actually, I should probably get a better capacitor. Oh, because I want to buy into the market before I leave, so I guess I'm just gonna suffer with it. Boom, boom, boom. So I get three shots at the most. The fourth shot will knock me out. So if I get into danger, I could use my side shield to block off an attack, or like to slam me into an asteroid. Because me shooting an asteroid is the last-ditch effort to stop the damn thing. I shouldn't be shooting to clear away. So once it gets to once because it get it starts out like at 500, 500. So I have like four shots outright from the get-go. If I go past four shots and just keep trying to fire, I'm going to knock out my power and go into that inert mode. So we can trade in the wizard for 391 grand. Elon Interstellar Alert Revival V. Midnight Explorer. First commercially available fusion craft version. The Model E included multiple groundbreaking innovations aside from its signature fusion craft, such as delivered unparalleled performance, features semi-autonomous pilot, autopilot, huge reaction wheel using its propellant as reaction mass, and a cargo bay that split that can split open to enclose a large payload. Dry mass 28,000. It can hold 5 through, though. Oh, the thing's the expensive. Far away father is my ship already. The God's Drive. The 23rd development of the 23rd century for the free states of Earth. Mystre Star Bus Eagle Prospector was designed for dedicated mining ship equipped with a robust asteroid grinder and an impressive cargo hold. The angle thruster layout prevented French thrust against the ringoid. Ringoid's daring wrench the thrust against the ringoid. They have thrust protection prevent like you knocking away ore. 6 crew, 2 drone points, 2 low stress points, and no hard points. No strong thrust hard points, so I would lose the grabber. Developed in the late 21st century, no longer in production, the Kalando RVM Cawthorn 212 is an interlunar cargo hauler, which boasts impressive cargo space, robust external frame that doubles a Faraday cage. Faraday cage, holy shit. Air Planet first design is not well suited for the ring environment. Exposed low G... Exposed low temperature radiator are notoriously fragile. The pylons, based on the thruster layout, make maneuvering challenging. And its converted life pod serves as a cockpit, limiting crew capacity. That's a big oof, but it has such a large storage. Traitor's child. So, we have 3 ships in the game. 4 ships, actually, because of the old first-class Comet right there. Oh, so the Minute Export does have a Oh, but this has a lower cargo hold. But it's a lot better. Ooh. Oh yeah, no, it's conceivably nearly better in every way, except that cargo is a bit lacking. That's the rich man's cargo vessel. Okay, I'm gonna play around in the middle of the market and hopefully not lose money. I've only lost 2 credits per of those purchases. So I need 11,600. Oh, I had 1 beryllium on me. So, 24, 98, 23, 28. So, we'll see if it actually goes up. And if I make my profit off of that. Either way, I had one earlier, so... And that was just me finding it. So that's free. Outright free. Because I already paid for the crew. Or already paid for the fuel and everything. But let me check the tuning of the xenon gas. So I have to... I use cheap xenon gas, meaning we don't pay for fuel. We don't have to burn fuel to get there. All ships equipped with low thrust economical xenon drives that allow for prolonged interlunar travel while using little propellant to drive into the ring. You can choose to use your main drive instead, cutting down the travel time significantly if cost increases propellant. So if I wasn't to do that, I'd already use 15,000 propellant. Like, how much is 15 grand in terms of propellant? That's 3,800. But I'm also thinking of, that's going to allow me to mine longer. Like, a lot longer. At the expense that's going to take me a lot longer to get there and a lot longer to get back. Last check, because I don't want to leave without anything I need. I got the mass driver, I got the ammo. Okay, if I can mine for a lot longer, I'm going to then sell this to grab more ammunition for the minimal market. Whoops. Did it just slam? I'm assuming it slammed into the thrust dressing because of how fast we're going. Oh god. Oh god. Okay. I saw those little fucking rocks and thought, oh god, we're gonna crash! We're gonna crash! Bunch of fucking iron out here. That's the second time. If you're going to speed, the arms is just a danger to yourself. Look at the maintenance panel. Ouchie! Iron, and then I just flew away. Thank you. How about no? I'm probably not going to make enough money to ever get a racing vehicle like that in a week. Good joke. How much beryllium is that? How much beryllium is that? That is like nothing. The only problem is you will still grab, like, worthless material. Feed that 15 grand down there. Yeah, the auto aim helps, like, a lot. Thank you. How much damage have I taken from this stupid arm's dumb shit? True question. Is am I recording? Yes, I am. Oh, wait. I'm dumb. This could have told me where everything is. So that's the big dangers, those things. Why do you keep wanting, insisting to go backwards? Oh, the chomper can smash small asteroids. Alright, we're good. We got no more space. We gotta go home. So I left with 50,000 units of fuel. So let's see, was my predictioning right? No! I lost money. Like, you know, I'm dumb. This is just how much it's in, yeah, whatever. Slowly getting better. In the 23rd century, a joint venture between Nakamura Dematics and Heavy Industries produced an autonomous mining drone that attempted to automate a ring excavation. While initially successful, the drone sort of developed a personality quirk of the neural and the neural, which diminished their performance over time. The drones engaged in social behavior rather than the excavation. The autonomous mining project was ultimately canceled, but the drones were quietly refurbished and rebranded it as mining companions sold to independent miners. Let me see something. What is my cargo bay like? Cargo bay, cargo bay, cargo bay. Cargo bay baffles. Eventually, I want this. This is like one of the ultimate things to get. Oof. That power draw, though. That power draw, though. where's my, where does it say my mat? Where does it say on here for cargo? Mass driver ammo, AV. Would it be in the equipment? And I look at the display. Underneath. Okay, that one's a little bit difficult to use. So about 118 K squared. I'm trying to see if that cargo buddy would actually be useful, or would he not be able to carry much at all. So I'm going to generate a lot more heat, although I'm very iffy on that, because my failure point's at 4.5K. Wait, is that every reactor's failure point? Oh, cradle mass of 500 kilogram, but they can hold 50 cargo capacity of 50 meters squared. So you can get like a chunk. I'm gonna watch it on this thing. Did it actually have equipment to actually grab things? Like, or is it more of to grab things for you? Oh, is it processing the smaller chunks? Like, the thing is, if it does that, then there's a legitimate thing I could do with this ship that would make it a drone ship. That I have two companions on board, get rid of the grabber, and put a gun on it for protection. Screw it. That's what I would say if I had the money, but I don't. Because I would only have $3,000 left over. Or I could get a smaller propellant tank. No, I'd lose too much propellant. Now, how much for insertion? Insertion is $10,000. Was 98 last year. So this is just stable stock. That's what I could just throw my money into for stability. Is there anything I can put on my ship? Oh, you get a basic bitch reconnaissance drone that flies over the ring. Array of low-powered lasers induce micro seismic shockwaves in the asteroids because the trace minerals present in the surface of the ice aids geologists quickly judging constant value and guiding drone. I'm actually going to spend my money on this. And then save the rest up for the buddy. One second. I'm gonna go tuning real quick. Do one thing. I wanna proximity alert. I wonder if I'm gonna hate myself. Run this a little bit colder because we run the yellow line a bit too much for my liking. Just a slight tad colder. Might as well attempt to play the mineral market. What is there that will possibly go up? 2 units of beryllium. MPD has a possibility of going up. Waters are so minuscule, it doesn't matter. Water is a rich man's game, because if you have a bunch of money and it goes up, you'll make a lot of money. Woo! Alright, what does the geologist say about right now? Remote scanner. Oh. How much damage did I just take by not paying attention? Again, grabby arm has fucked me. Captain, just before we left, I saw a post on Ring Chin, that someone got a big LADAR hit in this area. We might find it, be the first ones in the position to check it out, since the post went up. I gotta check it out. Who knows what my... I'm calling it right now. It's a pirate trap. Sure, why not? I'm not really gaining much anything. Anyway, I need to head deeper. Because I was a lot deeper last time, I think. That's the main problem, is I'm not deep enough, and I'm just kind of trying to mine in the outer ring. Did you seriously take me to the space station? Oh no. Oh, it's a space station. Oh, we have no minute of processor aboard the ship. Yeah, we have nothing aboard. Get away, get away, get away. We touched on the miners. All right, where the hell are we on the... We're not that deep. No. That's a thick ass. I might want to stick around with this guy. What's the drone estimating composition? Water, some VNF. Break my fucking thruster. Stop it. That's the one that has the stuff in it. I'm gonna have to tune this thing down. It's way too active. That's gone. Oh, we found a brilliant pocket. I didn't have money. This game's getting fucking laggy. Stop, for the love of God, stop! I'm not constantly redlining. Let go of the fucking rock! It's getting kind of a fucking annoying. I don't want it. It must be that because they're so process that it's causing problems in terms of what do I have? I have five. Has a bunch of beryllium near it, so I can come back here and get a bunch of mining done. Whoops, I didn't mean to do that. Storage. Now we're going to be doing a lot of quick jumps because I know we're a great mining spot for beryllium now. I don't need to do slow jumps, just slow drifts. Alright, this thing has saved me more times than I care to admit. So I'm very cautious to remove it. But I'm gonna want to try something new. Well, I think that was two runs. I'm so engrossed in this game that I completely forgot. Is this the second run or not? I think it is. So yeah, that'll be the end of it here. Got a mining campaign. Gonna see what it does. I hope the grabber doesn't keep screwing me. But it feels like it's more hurtful than it's helpful now, because you can't, unless there's a way to in the. Maybe I could turn it off. Maybe. It feels like it's a lot more detrimental. Yeah, no, I could turn it off. That's probably what I could do. To like, oh, release that. I don't want that. Turn it off. Alright. Anyway. Hope you liked that video. Please like, comment, subscribe. And peace.